Well, hi, everybody, and thank you for jumping into How to Set Up a Quiz. There are going to be a number of videos in this section, and everything is kind of interconnecting. Quizzes are very complex, and I do invite you to review these videos, but please set up a time and have either us come and see you, or you drop by and see us, and we'll have a workshop and get this put together. It's going to be a lot easier because it's a very complex subject. We are in the administration block of the quiz setup class. That's in the left-hand column, and the question bank is the last choice in a long row of options. Now, we're going to talk about categories in a few minutes, and you're going to see when we attempt to export from a previous class why categories are so important to use. So, this section is going to be very good if you either have a previous quiz you wish to bring forward into a new class, or in setting up your class, you determined you'd be doing a large number of quizzes and you want to set them up in this fashion. So through movie magic, I've gone to another class. I've come to the export choice, and we're going to go to the slide. And when I click export, you're going to see the question bank. And right at the top, under question bank, it says select a category. And I've selected samples to export. I've named my categories. I'm then going to see the two sample questions I have created, and I have placed check marks in there. And when I go to my next slide and I get a look at what we've got, it's going to show me, now that I've selected the items to export, see where it says export category right there in the middle of the page? This is why the categories are so important. I'm going to choose the Moodle XML format, and then at the very bottom of the page, I'm going to choose export questions to file. That's all there is to that. Let's come back to our live view in the quiz setup course, and I'm going to import that material that I've chosen. So I select import, and now you get a very, very large list of choices. And to remember which kind we chose? We chose the Moodle XML format. So I'm going to click that. I will tell you straight up, WebCT and Blackboard and sometimes ExamView do not come gently into Moodle. So having chosen the Moodle XML format, I'm going to drag and drop my folder into the area with the arrow. I could also use the choose a file method. Either is correct, and either is going to give you the result you need. You'll notice that an XML folder has a rather distinctive look if you're looking in your download area. I will then choose import. It's going to show you the questions, and I'm going to say continue. It will then show you a question bank that looks exactly like it did in the previous course. You'll see where the questions are, and this will allow you, notice after it says with selected, you can either delete them and edit, or you can move to another category if you had built a different category within your section. So let's talk about categories. Categories are very important because it allows you to organize your data. I recommend categories for grades, and I definitely recommend categories for questions. So before you build questions, let's select categories. When we do that, we're going to see the parent category, and I'm going to use that drop down, and we're going to choose top, and I'm going to create a new category. I'm going to call it chapters 1 through 3. I'm going to organize all of my questions to be chapters 1 through 3. I'm going to add a category. I'm going to add another category, and notice it wants to default to samples to export again as the top category. I'm going to choose the top, and now I'm going to call this chapters 4 through 6 and add that as a category. Now let's take a quick look at what we've got so far. We're in the top portion of the quiz setup page, and we've been adding categories. And notice question categories for course quiz setup. Our first item is chapters 4 through 6. Well, I'm going to use the down arrow and give it a click, and I'm going to move that down. I recommend also moving default for grade book 1, giving the arrow a click, and you may have to give it a second click to get it at the top. As you're moving things around, here's default for quiz setup. Let's go ahead and let's move that to the top. Now notice default for gradebook 1 shouldn't be there. That's from an entirely different class, and that's a result of importing. And it's okay because right after it there is an X. You give it a click, noticing there are zero questions in that category, and I'm going to choose the X and delete that category. This is one of the few places it's not very polite. It's going to take it right out, so be sure before you click. And samples to export, those are things I'm going to be working with later. So let's continue with this in the next series of quiz setup, and we'll show you how to move things around and how to create some questions. And again, please come see us in Library 315, or we'll come and see you. Give us a call at 3633, and we'll set something up for you. Thank you.